there. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily. I create mostly Salesforce tutorials, sprinkled in with some other related software tutorials. So today we're going to be continuing on with the dashboarding and reporting series within Salesforce. And we're going to be doing how to create a lightning table component within a dashboard. That is a mouthful. First things first, we are going to make sure that we are in the Sales Console or something similar to be able to see the Dashboards tab. If you cannot see the Dashboards tab, go to the 3x3. You can either search Dashboards, go to Sales. I'm going to search Dashboards and click on one of the ways that says Dashboards. From here, you can either go to a dashboard that you have already created or create a new dashboard. I've already created a test dashboard for the purpose of this tutorial and many other tutorials. I'm going to click on it. And from here, I'm going to click edit. If you went with the create new dashboard, you will need to come up with a title for your dashboard, and then you should land on this page without any of these other components here. Let's go ahead and click component. And for a lightning table, you don't need to have any grouping of your information from your source report. So I'm going to go to a tabular report, which I created, or I could do summary report. Neither of those have groups, but I happen to know that the joined report and the matrix report, these are all report formats that I have tutorials on how to create. All those have groups. So let's do a tabular report, and it will automatically show our table component as the only component that we can use. We can add groups from here. So we would be able to group the information by age, or the age of the, how, since it was created till now. We could group it by the amount. We could group it by other factors as well. And here we have up to 5 different columns that we can choose. I don't like to have opportunity owner, so I'm going to exit out of that. And an account name, because of the naming function between the account and the opportunity, it's a little redundant. So I'm going to close it. I like having stage. I'm going to get rid of fiscal period. And let's just add amount. And that's a good way to do that. You might want to have opportunity owner if this is a dashboard that has multiple sales reps on it. And you might even want to group it by there. But for the purposes of this, this is what we'll go with. We can sort it by a few different things. The fields that we have, the columns that we have. I'm going to group or sort it by amount and have it be the top amount is at, or the greater amount is at the top and it goes down. We can show different numbers. We can show scatter plots or chatter photos, excuse me, show the total, add conditional highlighting. We're not going to do that. Decimal places are automatic. We can show different groups. Let's see. I'm going to change the title of this to our top opportunities here. Because that's what we're really showing, is we're showing the top amounts of our opportunities. We could add a subtitle if we would like, if it gives more context maybe, as well as a footer. And we can choose our theme if we want it to be dark or light. I kind of like light. It's a little easier to see when you have so much text. From here, you can change it around. You can move it, drag it, put it there. A few things about the tabular report is that it'll only show a limited number of records. You won't be able to see all records that are on the report, but possibly just the top few, or you could have it be the bottom few. This would be great for possibly like the top sellers of our sales reps. So let's say you have sales reps 1 through 5, then you want to list them on how many closed one deals they've had in the past 90 days. And you can have a leaderboard of sorts. And that's kind of how you do it with that. You'd want to have that start on a source report and then bring that over. From here, I'm going to click done or save, excuse me, and then done. And this brings us to the viewer. We can refresh it, edit it, subscribe, download, save, new dashboard, and delete. We can also go to view report and see our source report, which is just our fun tabular report. As you remember, our component only had the top six. Here we have 31 records. So again, it's not great for viewing all of your data, but it's great if you want to view a very limited subset of your data, or maybe the top or the least. If I go back, then we are brought back to our dashboard. And that's how you create a tabular component or a lightning table component. You're also able, anything in blue will take you there to, it's a link. It'll take you to the opportunity. Yeah. Thank you so much for joining me. This is a part of a series on dashboarding and reporting within Salesforce. So that will be the top link down below if you want to learn more. If this was helpful, like, subscribe if you're feeling generous. Comment if this was not what you were looking for, and I will add what you are looking for to my list, or try and get back to you in the comments. So, thank you so much for joining me. I'll catch you in the next one.